end of the 20th century, we moved to contemporary postmodernism, deconstructivism, and pop art. These art styles emerged mostly by influence of mass media and popular culture.
The first artist you may think of is Andy Warhol, who capitalized on the idea of mass printing highly popularized and recognizable images, such as Marilyn Monroe and Campbell's Soup Can.
Andy Warhol's Campbell's Soup Cans of 1962 is completely responsible for the transformation between art and capitalistic mass production, both a critique and admiration, homogenous replication of something. Another notable contemporary artist, James Turrell, created the Rodin Crater in 1973. His work is analyzing how humans interact with light and space, which has highly influenced our views on design and aesthetics today. We'd also like to highlight the works of Keith Haring, who made easily reproducible and simple stated lithographic prints from 1989, addressing themes of justice, social protest, and equality. His most famous is Ignore Equals Fear and Silence Equals Death poster. Similarly, Jean-Michel Basquiat, artist of Fallen Angel in 1981, started as an informal graffiti artist who did murals around Manhattan, punk and hip-hop scenes in the 70s. Now he paints as a contemporary approach to expressionistic paintings, using socially aware and political active subjects in the ideas of his work. We would also like to discuss Sally Mann, a controversial American photographer who lived in rural Virginia. In 1984 to 1991, she made a series called Immediate Family. She staged elaborate portraits that shows sensualization of childhood, starting a conversation about how sexual thoughts and action happening in childhood happened a lot earlier than people want to admit or recognize. Artists in this contemporary time highly discussed matters socially, politically, and culturally. Mona Hatoum did performances with this in mind. One of the most prolific was her 1985 act of walking around in a ritualistic manner called circummanipulation, dragging Doc Marten boots tied around her legs as a social commentary on the same boots worn by the police and skinheads at the time. Some pieces were also highly controversial.
Yves Klein produced an anthropometry of the blue period in 1960 in which naked females painted their bodies blue and pressed them against a blank canvas. Klein reproduced these prints as a celebration of the female body, yet it raises several questions about the idealization and objectification of women, even in the modern day. David Hammons also expressed art with body prints. However, he instead used body prints of African-American men to portray their toil and oppression in America. Fred Wilson brings back questions of slavery in black culture today, how behind every story of white art and lavish life was a history of terrible suffering and oppression. He showed this in Mining in the Museum in 1992, in which he juxtaposed a shackle in the middle of shiny silver china. Kian Wiley is another extremely prolific artist who reproduces famous paintings of figures of power, replaces them with an African-American idol. This can be seen in his reproduction of Napoleon leading the army over the Alps in 2005. Lorna Simpson created in 1994 a portfolio of 21 wigs and lithographs on felt, all displaying African-American hairstyles. This is a contemporary and expressive approach to displaying African-American pride and recognition, reclaiming their culture and celebrating it. Contemporary art has no boundaries, as seen with Louis Bourgeoisie's 1994 spider sculptures that are extremely symbolic and autobiographical, signifying her relationship with her mother. Not only are these pieces of art, but they're large sculptures that are an organization of space for the viewers, a new perspective on how art can have narrative. And lastly, we introduce Peter Eisenman, a contemporary architect who created a memorial to the murdered Jews in Europe. In 2005, he opened a memorial art piece of 2,711 nondescript stone slabs in Berlin. Though he was criticized for the simplicity and lack of information of the memorials, his work was extremely symbolic and contemplative.
Not only that, but he designed this building of DAP, where we as students are privileged to learn this extensive knowledge of art history and design.
Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed our videos, learned a lot, and sparked a passion. Till next time, folks!